Good morning, children, and welcome to all of you in online classes. As we are doing revision work, so today we will revise the first chapter of Flamingo. And the name of chapter is The Last Lesson. Actually, the chapter is first, but the name is The Last Lesson. Dear students, this particular lesson has been written by one of the renowned and popular writers, Alphonse Daudet, who was born in 1840 and died in 1897. Mr. Alphonse Daudet was a French novelist and a short story writer, and he wrote many novels and many short stories. This particular lesson, The Last Lesson, is set in the days of Franco-Persian War during 1870 to 1871, in which France was defeated by Prussia under the leadership of Mr. Bismarck. Or unfortunately, the two French districts, Alsace and Lorraine, they came under the Persian hands. After that, in these two districts, the German language was implemented, and there was a rule that German language will be taught in these districts in place of French. So this lesson is about the French language and about the French teacher, Mr. Hamel. In this story, dear children, there are two important characters. One is little French, who is the narrator of the story, in whose words the story has been written. Or the second most important character is Mr. Hamel, who is a very strict teacher, who spent and dedicated and gave his services to that school 40 years, or who is famous for his punctuality, for his strictness. Actually, in this story, the narrator, little French, who in whose words the story has been written, he is describing the situation and the condition of classroom on the last day, how he reached to the class, to the school, what was the reaction of Mr. Hamel, how he reacted on that day, how the narrator or that little boy, little French, how he was surprised to know that their language was banned in their country, and how all the changes were made. He was shocked and surprised to know. Dear students, the story starts that Mr. Little French started a journey from his home to school, or he was going to school. He started, the boy little friend started his journey from his home to his school, or he was late. He was knowing that his teacher was very, very, very much strict, Mr. Hamel. Or if he will reach school late, the teacher will surely and certainly punish him. Or moreover, there was one reason that the teacher, Mr. Hamel, had given one homework, and the homework was a participle. Before one day, Mr. Hamel had given homework to all the students on the topic participle, or here Mr. Little French has not completed his homework. He was not knowing the single word of participle. He did not take pain to prepare and to complete his homework. So without completing his homework, Mr. Little French was going and moving towards the school. He was a little bit hesitating and frightened to know, to think about Mr. Hamel, that when he will reach to the school, his teacher will surely and certainly punish him. Dear students, so he decided firstly to not go to school. There was a good opportunity in front of Mr. Little French, either to go and enjoy nature or to watch the morning drill of Persian soldiers. But instead of engaging and indulging himself in these activities, he decided to go directly to school. Or when he moved forward, he found that there was a huge crowd near the town hall, in front of the bulletin board. That was also surprising and shocking for the writer. There was one doubt and question in the mind of Mr. Little French, what was the reason of that gathering. But instead of going and searching and knowing about the news, he decided to move forward and to reach school. Because in last 2 years, from that bulletin board which was displayed on the near the town hall, from that bulletin board he only received the sad news and bad news. Either it was the last battles, or it was, dear children, the orders of commanding officers. Different sad and bad news, negative news he had received. So in the beginning of the day, he was not in mood to go and to receive one more bad news. He decided to move forward. Or when he moved forward, he was interrupted and objected by blacksmith watcher, who was standing there with his apprentice, with his assistant. He also interrupted, he also objected, even he passed comment that why he was moving hurriedly. There was enough time to start school. Or narrator Mr. Little Friends took it negatively, or he increased his speed. Or finally, dear children, in few minutes only, Mr. Little French reached near the school. But when he reached near the school, he was very much surprised. Because normally, usually, whenever there is a school days, so there was too much commotion, there is too much disturbance which could be heard from the streets. But on that day, dear children, he has given, usually great bustle could be heard. But on that day, dear children, there was a complete silence. It was seeming to Mr. Little French
that it was either Sunday or holidays. Anyhow, he entered in the school campus. He found there was a complete silence, and then he reached to his classroom. He saw through the window, he looked through the window that his classmates were sitting in the class, and teacher Mr. Hamel was standing in the class and he was going to start the class. Mr. Little French was hesitating to enter. He was ashamed as he came late, as he reached late. Or anyhow, he opened the gate of his classroom. But on that day, Mr. Hamel, the strict teacher, had not inquired and asked to Mr. Little French that why he was late. Even he did not punish him. So seeing this strange and changed behavior of Mr. Hamel, the boy Little French was very much surprised. What was the reason? He was thinking, what was the reason of this change? And after that, he reached to his seat and he occupied his place. And after occupying his place, dear children, when he looked all around in the classroom, he found that the back benches, which were usually empty on that day, dear children, these benches were occupied by old Hesser, former mayor, former postmaster, and several other people of the city. So this was the strange thing. This was the surprising thing. Not only this much, dear children, he also observed that Mr. Hamel has worn a special dress on that day, which he used to wear on special occasions, either on inspection day or on prize distribution day. So many things were strange. One, change in the behavior of Mr. Hamel. Second, the back benches were occupied by old Hesser, former mayor, former postmaster, and other people. And third, Mr. Hamel had worn a special dress which he used to wear on result day or on prize distribution day or on special occasions. So these things were strange, or they surprised Mr. Little French. After that, Mr. Hamel started his class, started his lecture. He said to Mr. Little French that he was going to start the lesson without him. Or he also informed Mr. Little French and other students, including the old Hesser and former mayor and postmaster, that it was his last French class. Mr. Hamel informed all the students and other people sitting in the class that it was the last class of French. He informed Little French and others that from tomorrow the new teacher will come and he will teach German language instead of French. So it was the last French class. After this announcement, Mr. Little French understood why there was a change in the nature of Mr. Hamel, why all other people occupied the last benches, why all the things were looking strange on that day. He understood, because it was the last class. As announcement was made by Mr. Hamel regarding the last French class, to another side, Mr. Little French was very much sad because he was not serious about his study, and he was very thinking himself very much unfortunate and unlucky that he could not prepare and he could not learn his own language French, and it was the last class. He was thinking that how he spent his days carelessly, and all these things were in the mind of Mr. Little French. After that, Mr. Hamel asked one question to Mr. Little French. Or the question was regarding the last day homework participle. As in the beginning I told you ki Mr. Little French had not prepared and not knowing about participle, so he was unable to give the reply. When teacher Mr. Hamel asked to him, he stood up, but he started but not able to complete and speak a single sentence. But after that, Mr. Hamel was not angry on that day. Normally, usually he used to punish the students, but on that day he did not give any punishment to Mr. Little French, or he behaved very normally, very politely. Even he said that he was not going to give punishment to Mr. Little French, or he also said that if for his position and his situation, his parents were also responsible. Because Mr. Little French's parents, they wanted to send him to work in factory to earn money, to one. Or second, Mr. Little French was himself not interested in studies. Third, Mr. Hamel blamed himself also, because whenever in Sundays and in holidays he called Mr. Little French for learning, for teaching. So instead of dear children teaching to Mr. Little French, he was taking him to case the fishes. He was giving him the task to water the flowers, engage Mr. Little French in other activities. So three people were responsible: one, parent; second, Mr. Little French himself; or third, the teacher. After that, dear children, he started the lesson, or he taught all the things. He taught French also, and history also, and writing also, and grammar also. Mr. Little French, the narrator of the lesson, is telling ki whatever was teaching, whatever Mr. Hamel was teaching on that day, Mr. Little French was able to understand completely. Or he was regretting that why he had not concentrated in his studies before. Or on that day, each and everything explained by Mr. Hamel, all the students were listening carefully, especially Mr. Little French, and all the things were understandable also. Or he has given many things to them. Or in that short period of time, that strict man Mr. Hamel wanted to give everything to the students. He wanted to give each and everything, whatever he had in his mind. Dear children, after the grammar lesson, Mr. Hamel had new copies, or he gave those copies to the students. Or on the front page of the that copies, Franz and Elsock, Franz and Elsock was written. And the copies were given, grammar lesson was taught, and history was also taught, and many things were taught on that day. Or after that, dear children, Mr. Hamel was motionless. Dear students, he was thinking about his life and how he spent 40 years in the same school. He was observing each and everything of that school. Even he wanted to scan all the things in his mind. The trees which he planted before 40 years, now they were very long and tall. So he was observing each and everything, because he spent the major portion of his life, Mr. Hamel, or the former mayor and old Hesser and all other people, those who came there, they came to give the honor and respect to Mr. Hamel for his 40-year services. Or finally, dear children, he instructed to all the students as well as the people sitting there in the class that their language is their weapon. They should not forget their language, because with their language, French, they will fight for the freedom in the future. Though the German language will be implemented from the next day, but the warning and suggestion of Mr. Hamel was that they should not forget their own language, French. They should always keep alive in their mind, because their language is their main weapon to fight against the system. Or after teaching and telling all these things, dear children, Mr. Hamel became very emotional. Very emotional he became. Because 40 years he spent in that school, or moreover, the important thing that their French language was banned and the German language was going to start in their city, in their country, in their district. Or being emotional and sentimental, he stood up and finally he took a piece of chalk and he write on the board, Vive la France, live long France. Or after writing this statement, finally he instructed to the students, it was now the class was over. So this is all about this lesson, dear children. I hope you have understood. I will give you some questions also, and you will read line by line. This is all about today's revision. Thank you, dear children.